Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of Joe Sent Me. My name is Joe and I'm your host for today. Today I want to continue my series on five ouds and talk to you about five of the most daring ouds that are out there. And what I mean by daring is that this is a very oody oud, and I'm talking animalic, the strongest ouds you can buy on the market, the most authentic, the strongest ouds that you can get. The five that I'm gonna mention are five that I have experience with personally, so I know that they are absolutely amazing, strong ouds. Now, I wanna start by telling you that if you're just getting into ouds, I don't recommend checking these out. If you're someone that has been into ouds, you finally worn some things that are on the heavier side, you're dabbling now and you wanna get into a real oud, something that's really authentic, something that smells like royalty, and we're talking expensive. If you can afford to do this, and you have an appreciation for oud, and you're a lover like I am of oud, and remember, this requires an acquired taste. I mean, because if you start off with these, you're going to not want to do oud ever again. But I want to warn you that these are very strong ouds, and they're authentic. They're very pure. They're very, very good smelling, and they'll last 24 to 48 hours in strength. We're talking eau de parfum or pure extract. And here is my list. The first one that I ever tried out that was ever this strong, like I said, at first when I wore this fragrance, I was knocked out. It was just so animalic, so barnyardy, so poopy smelling. And I thought to myself, why? Why do I want to smell like poop? But it's not poop. It's just the way it is. And it goes away, by the way. So if you think you're gonna smell like poop, you're not gonna smell like poop. The first one was the Spirit of Dubai's Oud. And this is like an almost $900 bottle of perfume, and you'll see in the picture there how cool it is. Fantastic oud. It took me a while to realize how fantastic this was until I've seen other ouds. And I believe this fragrance has Siufi Oud, which is the skankiest of all the ouds. One of the skankiest of all the ouds. It has all kinds of ouds from top to bottom. It is very pure, very authentic, and very strong. It will last you, again, 24 to 48 hours. And it was one of the finest ouds I've ever smelled. So when I first put it on, I didn't know what to think. I didn't like it. I didn't know if I was gonna like it. But after it sat on me for a while, I realized, huh, this is not bad after all. And again, it takes somebody with a very acquired taste, someone very special, to appreciate this. The next oud that I tried out was Ramon Monegal's Soul of Oud. When I put this on, it reminded me so much of the Spirit of Dubai that I was reminded at first of how much I didn't like it at first. But then when I put this on, I knew what to expect. It came on the way the other one did too. It's strong animalic notes, but I appreciated it a lot more because I had finally dove into the deep end with the Spirit of Dubai. So I appreciated Ramon Monegal even more because my bar has already been set. With Spirit of Dubai, the bar is set up high. That is the bar. Ramon Monegal's Soul of Oud is up there. I mean, the bar is wonderful. This fragrance, really deep, really, really, really strong oud, long-lasting projection, all of these projection beasts. Sillage, definitely. By the way, I'm gonna include links to all of these. Check them out on their website. All of these are gonna come from different parts of the world. So if you're looking to actually order them or sample them or do anything like that, I would do my research. What I'm sending you are links to the direct website that the company is from so that you can check them out. The third oud was such a wonderful surprise because it's also another house from Spain, and it is Santi Burgas's Eau de Burgas. This fragrance also blew me away. It was just so beautiful. Again, strong, strong oud, long lasting. But again, because I had that bar set, because I've had the best of the best, which is the Spirit of Dubai, and because I had Ramon Monegal, I just knew when I put this on, okay, I know that it's gonna get a little skanky at the beginning, but this is gonna be good. And sure enough, It is. And it was so cool to see that the quality is so high on this fragrance. For it being as high of a quality as it is, it's one of the most affordable at just $300. It's one of the most affordable. I know that doesn't sound affordable, but $900 for an oud is a lot more than $300. Okay, now we're gonna get into another strong, powerful oud. And this is none other than Frederick Malle's The Night, which is a Dominic Ropion fragrance. Insanely expensive, by the way. More expensive than Dubai, by the way. More expensive than the Spirit of Dubai's fragrance. We're talking in the $1,500 range for a bottle. And strong, gorgeous oud. Again, strong 24, 48 hour oud. Projection beast. Special. Limited edition. These are not a dime a dozen. That's the beautiful thing about these ouds. Again, these are fall, winter, cold weather scents. Don't wear them in the summer. You will knock a brother out. Don't wear these in the heat. Don't wear them in a hot room. These are way, way better in the cold weather, in fall, when it gets really crispy outside, and in the evening when you're going on a date and you want to smell like Middle Eastern royalty. This Dominic Ropion The Night is just stunning, gorgeous. You've got to check it out. Again, I'll include a link down below so you can see where to buy it. It's just phenomenal. The fifth fragrance is the least expensive fragrance of the bunch, but is so impressive that something that is the least expensive can play with the big boys. And this fragrance was less than $100. And that fragrance, ladies and gentlemen, is Al Haramain's Oud 36 Nuit. Now, the regular Oud 36 is a fantastic fragrance. But there's not a drop of oud in that fragrance, except for in the name. And it is a beautiful, beautiful fragrance. I recommend it as well. Al Haramain makes some beautiful, beautiful fragrances. And I'm sure Al Haramain also has some really top level, top shelf ouds, but I haven't played with any of those. I haven't tried any of the high end of their stuff. And I'm pretty sure they have some really, really high end things out there. But I wanted to mention this fragrance because it has that strength, the longevity, the oudiness, the classic oud scent, but just this gorgeous, again, evening wear. A little dirtier, oud. And that fragrance is less than $100. I'll include a link on where you can get it. Normally it retails for like $250. Again, the most affordable of the bunch, but can hang with the bunch, and fantastic fragrance. So there you have it. That is my list. I'm sure that there's a ton of other brands. I didn't mention them all. There are brands that I want to try. I am just dying to try out Fragrance Dubois. I am dying to try out Russian Adam and Feel Oud, the fragrances from that brand. I'm dying to try his stuff because I heard his oud fragrances are just stunning. I am dying to try out a bunch of other ones, really. There's just a ton of other ones that I want to try out. I'm sorry if I didn't mention them all, and I'm sure there's some ones that are from the Middle East that I haven't even brought up because there's just so many brands in the Middle East that make a fantastic oud, but I haven't had any experience with any of them. So I wanted to keep this video completely honest, and I wanted to run, and not that my videos aren't honest, but I wanted to keep this video true to the things that I've tried, true to my experiences with the ouds, and hopefully you guys can have a new appreciation for oud after watching these videos. Hopefully you guys will be willing to be a little more daring and maybe start off with samples of these and work your way up. And you'll see, once you've acquired this taste, I'm telling you, this is caviar. Once you've acquired this taste, it's gonna be very, very hard to settle for synthetic, cheap, crappy ouds. It's just going to be very, very hard to settle for those fragrances. Yes, they may be easier to wear, but these kinds of fragrances are not your everyday thing anyway. You want to save them. You want to savor them. You want these fragrances to be something that you use on a really special occasion, and because they're so freaking expensive, Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments below. If you have any questions, I'd love to talk to you about oud and or anything else. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell so that you can continue to get great content. And also, if anybody asks, how did you hear about some of these brands? Because they're not an everyday brand. Please tell them, Joe sent me. Because I've had all this experience with these brands. And I want them to know that Joe sent me. All right, thanks for watching. Have a great day.